Donald Trump makes a stop at a Miami cafe. After leaving the courthouse.
This is what we're told and being conveyed to me via email. The president in this Cafe Versailles was an unplanned stop, but apparently known by some that he would be coming by. Let's listen again.
Please subscribe for more. Donald Trump just bought everyone food.
See too often after pleading not guilty to the these criminal accounts concerning his handling of classified documents. The president, the former president, stops by this Cafe Versailles. Experts in Cuban cuisine and the like. It's obviously quite the draw in the area. The stuff isn't altogether super cheap either, but the president shouting out a few minutes ago, food for everyone. So then everyone from outside started charging in to go in there and take him up on that offer. But again, the president indicating, and you might have said that there was a birthday wishes for him. Tomorrow, he is 77 years old, but the happy birthdays are out. He'll no doubt be experiencing a good many such wishes when he is in Bedminster, New Jersey. Tonight, for a big fundraiser, he's expected to make some remarks, a speech, whatever you want to call it, on that. Jonathan Turley with us again. Jonathan, thank you for your cafe expertise. I very much appreciate that, my friend. But let me ask you a little bit about this. If this is a guy who's frantic and worried about where this is going and legal cases that are building, he certainly had a funny way of showing it.
Well, you know, I'm not too sure what I would advise him about on the Espionage Act, but I think I would look him straight in the eye for my own John Dean moment and say, Mr. President, you need to get takeout at Cafe Versailles. On that, I would be very, very confident, having been there too many times. But no, it's obviously not affected his attitude or his appetite. So I think you're seeing what is coming in the future, in the rather near future, including tonight. He intends to speak about this case. He intends to run on this case. And there is some relevance to that. I mean,
God bless you, Donald Trump. Thank you for everything you do. Please subscribe.
Because if he is elected
to support him,
he could self-pardon. You know,
America loves you, Donald Trump. Mr. 45 and hopefully 47.
I think Jack Smith was so eager to refer to a speedy trial in his public remarks. I think Smith is concerned that he might not be able to get this trial going before the coming election.
Then you have to ask the issue, some of the stipulations that the judge has put on him about, you know, not talking to any witnesses, potential or otherwise. That's an expanding list, I would imagine, Jonathan. But then whether any limits are placed on how much he can say about this. Obviously, this is going to be a big campaign theme of his. He's the runaway leader in all the polls for the Republican presidential nomination. He's not going to mention this. It's literally his entire campaign these days.
Yeah, and
please subscribe for more.
To try to go nose-to-nose, toe-to-toe with him on a gag order, it could well lose. I would have great misgivings.
You think Joe Biden would do this?
Trump, in speaking about this,
I doubt it.
Because it is very much part of our national debate. You know, I refer to this as the most discussed indictment that virtually no one has read. And the reason is that for part of our country, this fulfills a pattern in their...
Again, Donald Trump buys dinner for everybody at
a Cuban
cafe.
And they're probably not going to read much beyond the caption.
After pleading not guilty, he stops at a cafe in Miami and is wished happy birthday by all the Cubans at the restaurant because tomorrow he turns 77. And from all of us here, happy birthday, sir. Many more. Have a safe trip back to New Jersey, sir. Hopefully someday I will be able to meet you.
So there, but the question is,
thank you for watching. I hope you subscribe.
Today.